Hi everyone and welcome back and welcome to another JavaScript lesson. Today we are going to talk about async await in deep dive. So our focus will be talking about how to convert the basic promises into async await, how to write async await code for our asynchronous code, and what are the things we should keep in mind while writing async await. What is the optimized way of writing async await? Either you are running async await inside a loop or you are executing multiple instruction using async await. Okay, so let's get started. So first we will talk about basic functions in JavaScript, like how we create a function in JavaScript. There are many ways. Either you can create an anonymous function like const hello. Okay. This can be a simple function and it can return something like I am returning hello. We are not using arrow function here. If we just convert this function into arrow function, then it will look something like this, async. We don't have any argument and we are returning. Okay. So what is the difference between any simple JavaScript function and this function? Here we are writing async for the function, right? So we are going to talk about async and await as a pair, but it's not necessary that await is always be there if you are writing async function. You can skip writing await, but if you are writing await, then your function should be async function. That is more important. Like simple function you are writing, this is how you create a function in JavaScript. If you are writing async function hello, right? What is the difference between this and this? The only difference between these both the functions is first function might be returning something. Okay, I am returning hello here, and here also I am returning hello. So the basic difference is it is returning the plain value and it is returning a promise. So whenever you are actually writing a function as async function, then that function will always return a promise. This function will return a promise, and how we will get the data from this? If you want to call it, then we will call it simply. But this code which we have written, where we are writing async function, it will return a promise, and we have to just do a dot then to capture the value from here. Okay, this is how it will work. So now we got the difference between normal functions and async function. Okay, in our definition, async await always comes together. Async and await, right? But it's not necessary that you put await in your async function. Like simple function, how we are writing is we are able to write simple async function. Async function say hi. Okay. And what this function is doing, it is just simply returning simple string. So you can see it is a valid async function. We are not using await anywhere. And if you wanted to capture the data coming from this, then you have to call this. It will return a promise and you have to just get the value out of it. Console.log, whatever the value we are getting. Okay, so here it is not restricting that you should write a await here. What it is doing, the async function will always return a promise. If you're not writing await, then it will wrap this inside a resolved promise value. Okay, so here we are not returning any promise, but this async function, if you are not returning any promise, then it will wrap it inside a promise. Or you explicitly define something like this, but it's not required. Why? Your async function already returning a promise, so you don't need to wrap it around another promise. It will be a performance issue. You can simply return the value, number, string, boolean, object, whatever you wanted to return, you can return that. Okay, so this is a basic introduction like how to write async function. Then in coming code snippets, we will start using the await with the async function, right? So simple code we are writing is this. We talked about this. Is here we are returning the greetings. Right, this is the async function we have created. And what this async function is doing, async function is returning a promise. So either you do something like this or you do something like this. Both are actually same thing. Okay, because async function will indirectly wrap this inside a promise and it will return the value out of it. Okay, so what we will do is we will talk about simple promises and how can we convert a promise based implementation to async await. So you might see these kind of questions maybe in the interviews also. They will give you the code snippet which is using the promises, and you will ask to return that code using async await. From there, they will get an understanding, okay, you know the JavaScript concepts properly or not, okay? So consider that we are doing a fetch operation, and maybe there is a coffee. This is some image you are trying to get, okay? Here, this is the fetch API. It will return a promise. So how we do it? We will just get the response, okay, and then here we will check the response, if response is coming proper or not. Like if response dot okay, this is not true, then what we will do is we can actually throw an exception, throw error, right? We can actually say HTTP error, that's it. Otherwise, if we got the data, then we will actually do is return response.blob. This is how we typically write the promises, okay? And this again is returning a promise. You can see this response.blob is also a promise. Here you are reading a file. Consider that if you are not reading a file and you are reading a simple HTTP APIs. Something like this, HTTP get, and how we do using fetch. First we get the data. Once we get the data, then we again do data.json, which again will return a promise. And here we will get the data, final data coming from APIs. Right, same thing we are doing for reading a file. Okay. Here we are doing response.blob. So it is this particular block again returning another promise, and you can loop onto it. Like if you wanted to download this and all, then you can write a code then again. Okay. And it will actually give you the blob which you can download. And I will be writing some code snippet to download this file. Like if you have this particular image, then we'll be writing some kind of a like this code. This is fine. And if I wanted to handle the errors, I will do catch error here, and I will just do a console.log error. That's it. Okay. Now this is actually promise based implementation. This is the first promise. This is the first dot then block. It is returning a promise here at then. We are doing dot then again. If any of these is failing, then we will go to the catch block. So this is the promise based implementation. Now let's convert that into async await. Okay. Now let's rewrite it. So what we can do is we can say async function and my fetch. This is the function name we have. Okay, so it is always a best practice to wrap async await inside a promises, inside a try catch block, sorry. Okay, first we will see what we are doing here is if any error occurred. So here we are writing try catch function. Now we have returned async block, async function, so we can write await here. Okay, this is important point. You can write await inside a function if your function is an async function. Okay. Even if you are doing some kind of a loop onto array, like if you are doing hello.map, okay? And if you are trying to iterate onto this, and if you are wanted to write something like return await and do something, it will throw an error because this function, the immediate outermost function, should be async for writing await. Okay, so you need to put the await here, async here, then only it will work. Okay, coming back to our previous example, we are trying to convert that into async await. So what we will do is let response, and what we are doing is await an API call. So this fetch is a promise based. If I will say hello.jpg, it will return a promise. So we can await for the promise, and here we can just check if we are getting the proper status code and all from this response. What we can say is response.ok, just for an example, if everything is fine. Otherwise what we can do is throw new error, and we can say HTTP error. So where it will go, we are throwing from here, so it will directly captured inside a catch block. Now either you can rethrow this, so whoever is calling my fetch need to handle this, otherwise you just do console.log. Here we got the response. If we got the response properly, then we will just go to the else block. You don't need to write else, so it will come here. If response is there, then what we can do is we will capture the blob data. Blob data, we can do the await again because it is again response.blob. So we are using await at two places. Await while fetching it, because this is also returning a promise, so we can put await. Response.blob is also returning a promise, so we can await for it. Now we got the blob data, and we can actually create an object URL and download this file. Same code block we can write. Okay, so just a little bit formatting. Here we are passing the same blob, and here we are downloading it, right? Same code we have written with the help of async await. What we did is we created a function as async, and all the promises, like fetch is returning a promise, let's await it. Blob response.blob is returning a promise, await it. And if any of this promise is getting rejected, consider that you are writing some custom function. Fetch my data. Okay, consider if you have written something like this, and here you have implemented this function. So what this function is saying, return promise dot reject, explicit reject we are doing. Okay, so this function is actually rejecting the promise with null value. So when you are calling this function, right, and you are returning a rejected promise, so what will happen is it will directly go to the catch block. So await is expecting a resolved promise. If this promise is getting rejected, it will directly go to the catch block. Here you can handle the errors. Okay, simple transformation we have done. Now we can see the other examples also. Let's go scroll it. So we will talk about simple hybrid approach where you are using async await and promises together. Like here I have written function clown. Okay, what this function is doing, it is returning a new promise. So how can you return a promise? You can actually create a new wrapper, promise wrapper inside it. Here you can resolve and reject. You can put anything, A, B, any argument. First argument is considered as a resolve, and second argument is considered as a reject. Here we have a set timeout. What we are doing in this, we are actually resolving the promise after a particular duration, like 1000 millisecond, and here we are saying resolve. Okay, this is the function we have created. Now how can we use it? How can we call this function which is returning a promise inside async await block? We will create async function message, or whatever we want to put a name. Here we will get a message. So what we are doing, await this clown function. Okay, and here you can say console.log message. So now you will see the difference when you write a promise or when you write async await. Await will not call this or execute this particular line until you got this promise resolved and you got the value. So clown, what this is doing, this is returning a promise. So it will wait for 1 second here. And once we got the value, we will be able to print that value here. Okay. So after 1 second, we will be able to see the value coming. Okay. Now, how can we actually write a multiple promises and write a await for multiple promises? Like I can say hi, which is resolving after 100 milliseconds. Similarly, I wanted to write say hello, which is getting resolved after you say 900 milliseconds, or you say, okay, let's make it 500. These are the two, say hi and say hello. And what we have written in this is other function say hi, this is our first message, and say hello, right? According to you, what will happen? So this is message and message one. So what will happen is say hi will execute. It will wait for 500 milliseconds. Okay. Second call is not happening, say hello, because say hi is in progress. So it will wait for 500 milliseconds. And here it will wait for 500 milliseconds more. And then it will execute, or it will put the console.log message. Right. This is what is happening when you have multiple await messages. So this will execute only after this is done. And both are independent. I mean, it is not dependent on this. We are not passing any data off which we are receiving from the first await to the second await. So is there any better way of doing it? I mean, you can actually do promise.all. Okay. So what we can do is const data, which we are going to get. We can say promise.all, and we will await this. So because it is returning a promise array, so we will await it, and we can actually, because promise.all accepts the promise array, right? So we can call say hi and say hello. Okay, so we will get the data, and here you can just do console.log. You can actually destructure this. You can just say whatever we are getting from the first and second, I will show it, A comma B. Okay, here if these both promises are independent, so you can execute them parallelly, right? So it will take less than 500 milliseconds. I mean, 500 is the minimum, so both are running parallelly. Here earlier we were getting 1 second, now it is getting only 500 milliseconds, right? So this is the simple example. Okay, now coming to here, we have written a simple code, and promise is always getting resolved. What if your promise is getting rejected? Okay, we'll talk about it. So what we are doing is we are just saying that based on some particular condition, we are resolving and rejecting a promise. So here I put this code, and what I'm saying is here first I'm creating the value, some random value, and this is what I'm returning. If value is there, if value is generated, I will resolve it, otherwise I will reject it. Okay, so this is what we are doing. And how can you call this method? We can call this method in some async function, because this is a promise. So I have written async function message. What I need to do is I will just call this function const message. So I will wrap it inside a try catch. Okay, here I can make a call const message equal to await. Here I just need to call this method, which is say hello. Okay, now it is actually randomly choosing either to resolve or reject based on this random value, right? So whenever it is rejecting it, so this is error handling of async await. Whenever this promise is getting rejected, it will always go to the catch block, right? So when you keep calling this message many times, there may be sometimes it will resolve, sometimes it will reject. So you will get lucky or not. Okay, these kind of messages you will see. So whenever the promise is getting rejected, it will directly go to the catch block. I mean, this is how you can handle the rejection of promises using async await. There are many other ways. Okay. And sometimes what happens is, consider that you have written some wrong code and any runtime error occurred. Here we are passing some message. Okay. Message dot to uppercase. I think this is the method to uppercase. So this will work if you are passing a string, right? Here you are actually passing some kind of a string. Await say hello string. But what if you are passing a number? So this will work fine. Now if I just pass a number, then number doesn't have a to uppercase. So it's a runtime error, right? So for these kind of, you should take care of these kind of errors which are happening at the runtime, and even the promise rejection is also coming to the catch block. Okay. So async await is like, now we have already talked about say hello is a promise based implementation. Now coming back to, let's wipe this out. Now we'll use this function for handling the APIs. So here we are writing either some exios.get, because this is also returning a promise. So we can write it. What we need with await is some method which is returning a promise, right? This is what we need. So it can be exios, it can be fetch a particular API endpoint. This will also work because fetch will return a promise and you will get the response. Then you can get response.json or response.blob based on the condition. Like here I'm awaiting this first, then what I'm doing, const data. Here also I will await response, sorry, here let's convert it into response. Here I will await to get the JSON data from the response. Now I got the data. If this data is array or whatever it is, you can just loop and return that data. Return data dot map. I wanted to return only a particular object properties. Okay, you will return that. So if any exception is occurring, then it will go to the catch block and you will be able to handle the error. You handle it here, or what you can do is you can actually write a catch block somewhere else. Here you have written this function. Now you call these APIs, might be some string argument, and here also you can catch. You can do it. So it is returning a data. So if any promise rejection happens, it will actually go to the catch, because async functions are returning promises. So let's talk about some of the best practices while using async await. So what we are doing is we'll just talk simple functions. Like here you are writing async function here, function test. So generally what we do is we write try catch, and then we put everything inside a try catch. So what is better approach in both of these two? Here we will just write something like await some function. Okay, instead of doing this, instead of writing try catch, can we just write simple function, and here we'll just return await some function. Okay, and we can handle the exceptions at this level. While calling this function, we can add a catch. So this is, I will say this is the recommended approach. You can go with the second one instead of the first one. Okay, this is the one of this. Now there are many basic things which you should always take care. Like, consider you have created this simple function, and what you are doing is you are wrapping promise into another promise. You might be thinking that it is pretty much straightforward, what is wrong with this? But what is wrong is async functions already returning a promise, so you don't need to create a wrapper around it. Even if you write it simply like this, this is returning a promise, and you can actually do a test function dot then you will get the value from here. Okay, this is also the same thing which we are doing. So unnecessary, this is unnecessary to return promise.resolve from that function. Okay, another thing which people might do mistakes is while writing async functions for multiple awaits. Okay, what I'm doing here is I'm actually getting const data1 by doing await some function. Okay, then what I'm doing is const data2. Here also I'm doing await for another function too. Let's say fn2. Okay, so you might be thinking, what's wrong with this? These are the two different functions and having returning promises are executing fine. But here function 2 is always have to wait for this particular line to return the promise, right? So instead of doing this, so this is the one way. What we can simply do is we can assign these promises to some variables. This is approach 1, let's say. How we can refactor this code is we first assign these calls, the promises which we are getting, some function promise into some variables, and then we can write await, respective await for these calls. Okay, here we can get const message one, let's say, and here you can do await for data one. Data one, and simple we can do message two for data two. So what is the difference now? What we have changed is there is a big difference between the first approach and second approach, and why? Because now here we are, what we are doing is here we are doing await on these two promises, so they are not dependent on one another. We already have the promises assigned to data one and data two. You are just awaiting them, so they can run parallelly instead of waiting for one another. Okay, similarly, like if you need to execute promises parallel, then always put these things inside a promise.all. Here it just accepts the array. Here you can put data1, comma data2. Okay, here you can actually call it as messages. It will be just an array, and from that array you can capture the values. Okay, so these are just some recommendations which you can have in your while writing the code. You just need to take care of these things. Okay, so apart from that, we already talked about the try catch, how to write them and how to handle the exceptions. So these are some of the recommended approach, and this is how we do it. Other than that, while writing the async await, always take care of, like, if you can run two promises parallelly, then always do the promise.all. If you can't run these parallelly, then don't make them blocking code, like blocking to one another. Always you can just write await, first get the promises from both. I removed that code. So this is the mistake of the developer too. So this is what we are doing. That's it about async await in this JavaScript lesson. In more videos, we'll talk about more aspects about JavaScript.